That's a really good question. I think parties can, number one, make sure that they have the right arbitration clause in their contracts. I think sometimes when negotiations are happening, no one really focuses on the arbitration clause, whether it's Indian ad hoc arbitration, whether it's SIAC, LCIA, or some institutional arbitration, and where the seat will be, what will be the law in mind for in case there's a dispute. I think those, if someone does proper planning around the arbitration clause, I think one is it, if there's a dispute, things become much clearer. And I think also trying to mediate and coming to some sort of resolution before it reaches international arbitration, I think is the right way to go. I don't agree with that, actually. I've been a part of many arbitrations as an expert witness, and I can tell you the process runs pretty seamlessly. There are tight timelines. For instance, recently I did an arbitration in an institutional environment where my cross was for 2 hours. So it was very specific. A party had 2 hours to cross-examine me. It was very unlike a litigation where you really don't know the timing. You don't know when you're going to go up as a witness. So I thought it was very much organized. And I think it runs in a very structured way, and you are sure to get a decision in a time-bound manner. And I think it's far more transparent. So I kind of still prefer arbitrations for commercial disputes. I think the experience has been great. I mean, you've got a great audience of general counsels. I think we should do more such events to increase the awareness around arbitration. Thank you. Thank you.